Hello there. Today we are going to talk very briefly about the evidence-based practice pyramid of information types. This here is one of the many representations of the evidence-based practice pyramid of information types. At the bottom are your clinical reference texts, which are already out of date the second that they are published because it takes a while to write those. Plain old literature reviews, opinions, expert or otherwise. Notice that they are at the widest part down here. That means there's a lot more of them, and they can be a base to your house, much like your textbook, but they are not at the heights of the evidence-based practice thing, and I will show you. At this part, it is more a, this is what I think, or this is what others think, but I'm not looking at it too critically. Next up, you will see lots and lots of case reports, case studies, and things called case series is also in the literature. And these reports are just one case or a few cases that get described. Now, question, are you going to base your treatment of a patient, say, moi, on one case report that you read? Because that patient may be very different from me. Now, you might, if that patient's close enough to me, you might not. That's where your clinical thinking comes in and your experience and your expertise and all this other stuff. Ooh, that was exciting. All right. Next up on this here evidence-based practice information type pyramid, the bigger studies, the fancier ones, the randomized control trials, the cohort studies, they have more people in them, much bigger studies. Hopefully that got good controls. This group gets candy. This group doesn't. Here are two groups that got candy. Let's compare them. Or one group that got the good candy, one group that got the bad candy. Comparing people like that. More people hopefully gives you more diversity so that hopefully the findings from that study might be more applicable to your patient or moi. Woohoo! Next up, evidence-based guidelines. These are what an evidence guideline is a synthesis of studies with expert recommendations drawn from the findings thereof. Now, these can be put out by a fancy organization. These can be put out by a government. These can be put out by an entity like a big hospital or something. And at the very tippy top, notice it's a lot smaller. There are fewer of these. In gold are systematic reviews, particularly the Cochrane variety, and meta-analyses. What these do, they take findings from studies and reports, look on down here, and they analyze them systematically and or mathematically, because they may do both, to find what the preponderance, big P preponderance, most of the evidence going across suggests. And evidence always suggests because nothing is ever proven. Not even me just saying nothing's ever proven is actually proven. Because remember, information gets found out all the time. There are new treatments. There are new findings. There are old treatments that come back into popularity. All kinds of things. And so these systematic reviews and meta-analyses smoosh the information from these other things together. And they try to find what the preponderance is. They may go at their groups, you know, mathematically, all kinds of things. All right, and the places you can find this type of information. For the systematic reviews, for free, you can go to Cochrane.org and click on their Cochrane Reviews site and then get in and you can browse the summaries of the reviews, which is quite often enough to really get a good feeling for their overall findings. And Cochrane is a gold standard, may I throw in, because they have very, very set methods for how they conduct their systematic reviews. So you can go there and you can find summaries for free, or you may have access through another entity to the full text thereof. But do know the full text thereof, a lot of it is just talking about how they did the review, not necessarily what their findings and their conclusions are, which will be available in the summaries. All right. Next up, for finding them evidence guidelines from just about everywhere, you can use a service of the U.S. government, the National Guideline Clearinghouse at guideline.gov. This brings together guidelines from all over the planet for treatment recommendations from all kinds of fancy places. For other layers of evidence, you can use the resources available from your own library, your professional association, and also another service of the U.S. government. You can use the PubMed Medline interface and look at their clinical queries stuff. And you can just go into PubMed however you get there and click on clinical queries. Thank you.